hitting the bench, hitting the quarter mile with a 69 Plymouth GTX hardtop Pro Street 125th scale from AMT. Round 2 sent this over for review. Check out the cool options in the box. Let's take a look at all the parts. We'll start on the opposite side of the table today. Check out that decal sheet. Those are very 90-ish style graphics on there. I love it. You can see we've got gauges on this one, multiple extra gauges on this one, license plates, we got the dashboard gauges, we've got logos and emblems. These are large Plymouth emblems here in white that are kind of hard to see. We've got red and white and gold striping. We've got marker lights on there. We've got a lot of options to throw on your car if you decide to use them. We've even got side glass, which is pretty rare for these models. We've got back and front glass, and we've got red tinted taillights. We'll see all the glass later when it's safer to take it out. We got a nice set of four tires. There is only one way to build this car, and that's as a drag racer. We can check out these Mickey Thompson drag tires. Nice tread pattern, black wall on one side if you're not a Mickey Thompson fan. And then we've got the front tires, which are smooth wall, no name engraved on there, with a really nice tread pattern on them. Two chrome trees total. Check out that. We've got corners, we've got bumpers, grille. We've got intake systems. We'll flip it around in a second. We've got full dash cluster there for gauges. We've got a high-rise intake. We got our nice wheelie bars, which are all one part, which is awesome in those cases. Makes life easier. We got one set of wheel options on this one. We've got centerline style wheels. I really like those, definitely with that 90s motif. We got shocks. We got two types of air cleaner. We got the triangle air cleaner here, and we have the larger Mopar style air cleaner. We got Hemi heads on this one. We've got two styles of shifters, differential components, carburation. Excellent stuff on the chrome tree. We've even got some exhaust tips on there for you if you wanted to run exhaust all the way back out. I don't know why you would on a dragster, but hey, they're on there for you to use, or they go in the parts box. We got some nice white styrene on the other side of the table. Beautiful racing bucket seats with belts molded in top and bottom. Nice detail on those. Those will go right in. You don't have the components in here to build a completely stock GTX, but it's not extremely far off. It's just the Pro Street version. Nice interior pan. Obviously, back seat is deleted as it should be. We've got the big tubbed out chassis. Check that out. Rails down the center, all widened for you, all set to go. That's gonna fit the purpose right there. Let's get some more plastic out here. Got a good amount of parts in this kit. We got our roll cage assembly, nicely done. We've got our differential all set up, or spool. We've got our springs on that one. Can highlight those. We've got our stock GTX hood with the air grabber on either side. We've got the optional hood scoop. The hood is scored so that you can cut it out easily. And we've got our door panels. Nice detail on those. And they'd still be in a Pro Streeter like that for the most part. We got some suspension parts. We've got engine parts. We got a firewall. We got a full stock dashboard. We've got radiator surround. We've got hood hinges, drive shaft, steering spindles, horns, battery, overflow tank. We've got our nice Pro Stock exhaust system. We've got our headers and our short mufflers out the side. We've got our front inner fenders. Nice detail on those. For the engine tree, we've got our wheels and wheelbacks, oil pan, cylinder heads, block halves. Transmission is separate on this one. Belt and pulley system, water pump, starter, small accoutrement. You could do a nice working on diorama with those drilled out cylinder heads. You can see the backs are open and hollow. We've got our front suspension and frame. Got the K-member there. We got sway links. All set up, steering, all put together. And we've got the body. One tiny piece hanging out on the side all on its own is the steering wheel. Then we've got that big GTX body, which looks every bit the part. Beautiful body. Nice strong molding on there. Door panels. We got the little GTX emblems underneath the fenders there. We got the nice long piece of trim. Beautiful back end. Looks just like its cousin. Nice looking body on there. And that is the extent of the plastic in the box. Now I'm going to soak that plastic, like I always recommend doing, with some Simple Green. Check out my video on cheaping painting model cars with cheap spray cans to see how I do that. And we will be back when I get some sub-assemblies done. Couple hours of assembly time and some decisions to be made, and the kit goes together really well. So far, no issues with fit. No, I even tested the body over the chassis once I had the chassis ready to go, and that just snaps down. You just spread the body a little bit and it drops right down over it. The front fenders and the back of the front fenders, they just pop right over the firewall, and the radiator supports here are all set to go. So what I'm going to be doing is painting things up in similar colors and cutting off trees to assimilate that. We got the dashboard I'll be using, the battery. I don't know if I'll be using the washer bag or the horns. I mean, would you on a drag car? You'd probably take those out to eliminate weight. We got our master cylinder there. We got our radiator, our drive shaft, and our radiator hoses. So those all need to be painted up, and we're going to put them on the same tree. I'm going to be leaving some stuff chrome and doing other things with the chrome that I don't want. All these parts here on these trees, the wheelie bars, the grille, the rear panel insert, the electric fan, or the fan assembly, it's not electric, it actually goes into the pulley. That I'll be gel coating, and then we'll be doing a lot of black washing and detailing with that later. So first I'll get in and get that a matte coat on there. The differential goes on separately, and the springs, I want to paint them completely separate from the rest of the car. So I've just assembled them on their tree, and then I can paint them together and detail them on their own. The seats, of course, will be painted, so I need to just leave those on their little tree, get those painted, and I can grip onto it easily. Anytime you leave something on a tree, when you get done snipping it off, if it's visible where you cut it off, you can just squirt a little bit of the paint in a can or a matching brush paint and just paint it on. These are the wheel backs. I've got them glued solid. You could leave them loose if you wanted to let the wheels roll, but I don't want that. And that's our very simple belt and pulley system on the same tree. So we'll get those painted up, or at least primed together. Steering wheel, of course, all on its own needs to be painted. We've got our headers together. Did not attach those to the engine yet. I'll do that after the engine is actually in the vehicle. So I've got those glued together. They clamp together on the back and go together lovely. They line up. You can see they are very attractive, and they do line up nicely for that Hemi, so we're not going to have a problem. The centerline wheels, definitely want to gel coat those. I don't want them chrome. I want to put a matte clear coat on them and then detail them separately when we get them out, so they look like metal to me. The valve covers, you could leave them chrome if you want to do it as if he had a race Hemi under the hood. I want to do it as a street Hemi, so that he's modified and raced with. So I'm going to end up priming these and painting the valve covers on my Hemi because that's the look I desire. The exhaust, I haven't decided if I'm even going to use this exhaust yet, but I am going to get it painted, and we'll see how it looks and how it fits underneath the chassis. We've got our interior tub ready to go. The GTX isn't extremely fancy on the interior, so we can go ahead and spray it and hand detail. If it was a really fancy interior, I would have left these panels off and detailed it separately. The roll cage, you have to drill out the holes for these. A 1/16 inch drill bit works perfectly for those holes. They're pre-marked underneath the bottom. So just go ahead, drill those out. Place your roll cage in there. Then glue your two top parts of your roll cage on, let it sit for 20 minutes, and you can pull it off, and you're ready to paint everything separately and detail it. The body really doesn't need any work except for removing the supports between the front fenders when they mold it, and then just checking to see if it needs any major cleanup. The hood, as you can see, goes on there nicely. I did cut out the hood. They do, like we saw in the parts review, they do open up the bottom. This is a tool you can get from any model place. It's actually a dental pick, and you'll scribe around those lines from the bottom. Then you'll use your hobby knife to finish the cut, and then you can install your hood scoop, and it looks like a real hood scoop, and it'll fit that high-rise intake, and it sits on that GTX beautifully. So that is a nice job there. And as you can see on the outside, it is a seamless fit. That hood scoop goes on there beautifully without any issues at all. So I like it quite a bit. On the chassis, You can decide how much you want to glue on and how much you don't. Your rear suspension and drive line will fit right here into those large holes. So I'm going to be painting this separately. We've got our front frame, our K-member, and our sway bar. Now you could put these on separately. You could leave them off, paint them separately, attach them. Your firewall, your radiator support, and your fenders were separate like we saw. And as you can see, they fit on nicely. They line up perfectly. They've got large locating tabs on the bottom. You're not going to have any problems squaring up your fenders. What's nice about those being separate is if you want to do this as a diorama where he's got the fenders off and everything, or he's just putting an engine in or whatever, that is easy enough to do with this kit, which makes it very nice. But otherwise, I've got it in there. And yes, you can get the engine in. It will go in around that radiator support. It just is a little fiddly, but you'll get it in. But do not attach that radiator. You're never going to get the engine in if you decide to put that radiator support on first. The engine itself is assembled. You can see on top I've got that high-rise intake that I will be painting separately. I did sand off the chrome so that model glue would hold in this particular case because I'm going to be repainting the whole thing. So I'll just put that on the bench, get that sprayed. That is a nice high-rise intake for the carburetors to go onto. The transmission is completely separate from the engine. I did assemble it and glue it on because I don't mind masking and hand painting, and I want a more sturdy structure than I want perfect lines between the painted parts, which I always get them pretty good to begin with anyways. But you can see the heads attached, the block, the water pump assembly, the oil filter, the distributor, and the starter are all separate parts that go on beautifully, and that is a nice looking Hemi. This would be a nice engine for any other vehicle as well, with that really nice transmission off the back, bell housing. All the nice details on that engine are exquisite, so it's a very nice engine to be used anywhere else as well. Things I'll be leaving chrome, the bumpers of course, I just want to leave those standard chrome, and the velocity stacks, the shifter, the alternator, the carburetors we can work on with black washing, and the rest we won't be touching. So I'm going to get all this stuff over into paint, and as always, come along, chill out to some music. stopping for a progress report on the GTX Dragster. Check out those Mickey Thompsons. They look awesome once they are sanded down. I mean, they look good shiny, but when you touch the sidewalls a little bit as they go around, just the edges, make it look like he's actually been drag racing it or at least driving it. The tires look pretty sweet, so we've got those all set up. We've got the no-names on the front all ready to go. Those will be mounted on the center lines. Check out how awesome they look with a little black wash. If you coat it with flat clear first, doesn't matter the brand, then give it a little bit of a black wash, you get this really nice metallic look to them that enhances the chrome without being overly shiny and doesn't dull it down too much. You get that beautiful natural metal aluminum finish to them. I've got my wheel backs all set up. Those are ready to glue together. We've got our differential ready to be set on the rear of the car over the shocks. The black wash is dried and they look nice back there. We've got that big Hemi put together. Look at that. That not a sharp creation. That's that, you know, if you wanted to use this in any other kit, you would be all set to go. Love that high rise, love the carburetors on top. I'm gonna go with the velocity stacks instead of air filters, and those just press on. We'll just need a tiny bit of glue when we're all done. So I like how those look. Those came out lovely. That will all be hidden underneath the nice hood here. We've got that all set to go with the black inside the original screens for the air grabber. We've got our grille all done. See how we did around the lights as well. We did our black in there. We've got our GTX logo sticking out. We've got our rear emblems done. The taillight bezels are set to push in. We've got our wheelie bars all washed and flat coated, and we've got our radiator washed and our pumps on the side there. So those are all set for under the hood. The headers look excellent in their aluminum color. No issues with those at all. Over the black, painted up, ready to be bolted onto the side of the Hemi after we locate it inside the vehicle. Those are going to look real nice on there. We've got our dash done. What I did was they include that nice set of gauges to go right over the stock dash because he's not going to leave that in there for a dedicated drag racer. So I put the nice gauges in there. They do include a full set of gauges for the car if you want to use it, but I'm going to save those because there's a lot of cars that don't have good dash detail and I can use those decals. But this one, it's all embossed on that aluminum plate. So I flat coated it, black washed it, used a black marker to get inside each one, and then rubbed it off the metal and just used some green highlights and stuff for lights. And now we've got a nice looking dashboard for a race car. We've got our drive shaft, our radiator, and our coolant lines and our master cylinder all ready to go in later. Our battery, I'm not going to use the washer tank or the horns. All that's going to be out of the car. He's not going to use any of that stuff. So we've got a nice dash like that. What I did then was you saw me overspray that with the original sage green that the GTX was in. So the fenders and firewall and radiator support are all the stock color. I oversprayed the green a little bit, and then I oversprayed the new section only with the purple, and over a little bit when he repainted the car after he tubbed it out and primed everything black underneath. Then we went and got some of that overspray from the body on there. It's just the look that I wanted to go for. The interior looks awesome with the original sage green sheet metal behind underneath the back seats. We've got our roll cage in there and a contrasting black. That oil rub bronze really makes a nice contrast. We got our beautiful seats in there. I got the shifter in. I even gloss coated the rubber that's built into the carpet because he wouldn't have torn that out. And then just use some silver highlights on the door panel just to bring it out a little bit. So we've got some nice interior detail on that car. Gonna look great with the dashboard and the body. The final part ready to go. Got the glass glued in. Just use some Mod Podge. You just brush it on around the edges. Always use gloss Mod Podge in case it gets on the glass and you wipe it off. It'll still dry crystal clear and glossy. Did all my accents. The GTX logos are in decals. The turn signals I did, they do have decals for them, but these are set way in. So I did silver around them, and we'll end up dripping some Tamiya clears in the front and rear. So that is all set. Now that purple in person looks really purple on camera. Looks almost kind of bluish, but it's actually a nice deep purple. So I'm hoping in the final pics that'll show up well. I'm going to keep working. Once I get the interior done. We'll get the engine mounted in the chassis, get the radiator, get the battery and all that stuff all set, get the wheels and tires together, get the dashboard on. We will come back for a peep. One last peek before I wrap this beauty up, just to give you a look at everything in a closer detail than we would get with the final or with the pictures with the body on. Check out that wheel and tire combination. That is tough. That is nice looking. That's going to go on there real slick. And those front tires, those look awesome. Those look just like aluminum now, exactly as I wanted them to. The hood's ready to go. We'll be able to drop that on the body. The interior is all together. All I had to do was put the steering wheel in the dash and insert the dash. This is a friction fit. The fit is so nice on there. We got our shifter in there. We got our black carpet. We got our door panels. We got our nice seats that were glossed up. And then we got our belts on them. And we got that awesome looking roll cage. That is a nice unit there with the flat black package self. The green on the inside, I like that little accent, which lines up perfectly with the green under the hood. We got our Hemi installed. We got our fan installed, radiator line. We've got these two little tanks here. I did not put the battery in. I left the battery shelf there. He would more than likely have the battery back here in the trunk, so I left it out. So you can take a look at that. That's nice looking, and we'll go underneath for a peek underneath. You can see we still got some green left. We got purple on the sides. We got the new with the no green at all towards the back where he tubbed it out and then sprayed his car. I did go ahead and use the exhaust instead of just out of the headers. I think it looks really nice that way. Blacked out the tips. I've got the suspension arms and the wheelie bars all the way out the back with that drive shaft and that differential. We are all set up with the springs on that beauty, and we are ready to go. And then we've got the body all ready to press on. Check out the taillights on there with our bumpers. Everything lines up beautifully. And we got that good looking nose on that GTX. Very sharp looking car, just like the Roadrunners. So those are all the parts that are going to be together. All I have to do is put the interior in the body, snap the body down. The body fits tightly over the firewall and the radiator support. That's what pretty much holds it together. Then I'll press those wheels and tires on, and we'll be ready for that final, which I'll see you for in just a second. Check out the final on AMT's 1969 GTX hardtop Pro Street, done my way. Now, when you get done, if you decide to use some decals, you can use them any way you want. You can decide how to display them, how to set them up. These are how I chose to use some of the striping on the side. Because of those centerline wheels, everything I see with centerlines reminds me of the 90s for some reason, when American Racing Wheels made those, and they were extremely popular with everyone, and a lot of people had them on everything, so that's what it reminds me of, and so do stripes like that, just really remind me of the 90s. So you will see that you have a lot of stripes left over to decorate the car in any way you see fit with all kinds of detail. We got gauge decals left, we got all kinds of stuff. This kit is ripe for a lot of cool parts in it. You cannot build a stock GTX with it, but you really can make a very nice Pro Street. Little tip, if you decide to use the hood scoop when you build yours like I did, because I like that scoop look on there, the velocity stacks will not let the hood come all the way down. It won't even be close. It'll sit way, way above where it should be. And there's no way to fix that unless you just, these friction fit, so you can just take those back off and run it with open carbs, which wouldn't hurt anything anyways, through the scoop there, and then you've got a nice looking Pro Street. If you want to use the velocity stacks or anything that make the engine that much taller over the top of the carburetors, you're going to have to eliminate that scoop and just run open air like it is on the box here, where it's sticking way up through the top. But otherwise, it does fit underneath the scoop, and that hood fits beautifully, so I'm glad it's on there. And that hood scoop looks like it was designed with that. Once you cut that hole out, that seamlessly fits on there so nicely. You can see the intake and the carbs through the front of it. It looks really nice. I love my metallic purple on there. Those centerline style wheels are so gorgeous with that flat coat and a little bit of black wash. The Mickey Thompson meats are huge and look awesome. The taillights go together so nice. Everything just press fits in. You have to glue the GTX logo on the back, the entire trunk piece, but the bumpers just fit into their location holes like we saw in the parts review where you saw that. The grille just pushes into place, one drop of super glue, and it's all set. The interior shoves in, the glass all lines up exactly like it should, and we don't have any fit or finish issues. It is a very tight fit over the front of the radiator support and the firewall. You will just need to spread the body, but it does it easily. It drops over it, but it's a very tight fit, and that's what holds the car together. On the back side, you just glue it in with two drops of CA along the back. It'll pretty much hold with the firewall and the radiator surround, but you just want to glue that in just to make sure you don't have your back end drop down. So, and surprising to me, even though that differential is, you know, assembles with the only two springs and the drive shaft for support, and then the two ladder bars slash wheelie bars off the back, that's a really easy opportunity when I showed it upside down to get that wonky, and yet without any hard work, all four tires sit on the ground. I didn't have to adjust anything. If you leave the front axles the way they were assembled, you can turn those front wheels left and right as well and have it posed for your shot if you so desire. A lot of ways you could build this thing. You could open up that trunk because there is a full bottom underneath here and detail the trunk, put that battery in it, whatever you wanted. It's a really nice car, and I'm thankful for Round 2 for sending it. This is out on the market right now. You don't have to worry about a pre-order. They have it in stock. I will put links below for Auto World Store, links below for Model Roundup, who's very cool, sends me kits all the time, just like Round 2 Models does. And we will see all of you at the next review. And as always, when I close out, make sure you build for you. You use the paint you want to use. You decorate your car. You use the decals. You build the engine. You put the high-rise on. You don't put the high-rise on. You build it however you want. Just make sure that you have fun doing it. Stay positive. Stay healthy. Stay safe. We'll see you at the next kit review.